This week on Maker Update, a massive LED wall, donut propellers, a massive useless machine, ScribbleBuddies, Octoprint controllers, and making tools with your leftover epoxy. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we find all the cool stuff people are making across the internet and show it off to you. I'm Tyler Weingartner, and I hope you're all doing great. We've got a fantastic show for you, so let's check out the project of the week. If you've ever wanted to have a massive LED wall, this Instructable by ChrisParkerTech is just for you. Measuring in at 7 feet wide, this thing is large enough to dominate a wall in your house, but it can be built for just around $500. The display is driven over Wi-Fi, so you can use it to mirror your desktop, display GIFs, or use it as a music visualizer. The display is made up of several lengths of WS2812 LED strips, arranged into neat rows along a cardboard backing board. Once they're all wired up, each pixel is isolated using these 3D printed grids. Printing these grids is where most of the work in this project goes. Chris mentioned that he used almost 4 kilograms of filament to print all the parts for the entire wall. I'm willing to bet that if he had access to a laser cutter, you could probably make these out of cardboard or thin plywood to bring down the production time, and maybe the cost. The full-size display is made up of 4 individual panels all working together, so there's a little bit of modularity in the project. Each individual panel is driven by an ESP8266 microcontroller. The software managing them is called LMCSHD and communicates with them via WebSockets. Once you have them located on your network, you can set up the geometry and coordinates of your panel. Overall, this looks like a really fun project that's thoroughly documented with an incredible result. If you don't want to commit a full wall to this one, you can just use a single panel, or make each panel the size that you want. Chris's Instructable includes a full bill of materials, 3D printed files, code, and a video showing each step in the process. Time for some news. A new patent from MIT recently highlighted Toroidal Propellers. These are exactly what they sound like, propellers that are in the shape of a torus instead of the standard linear blade. The toroidal shape reduces drag on the propeller, which makes them more efficient. And the other benefit of the shape is that because the leading edge is distributed all along the blade, it disrupts the air less, allowing it to operate a lot more quietly. Unsurprisingly, a lot of drone folks are excited about this. If these new propellers can reduce the noise of drone operation, that could be pretty exciting. More projects. On Instructables, I found this scissor arm CNC pen plotter called the ScribbleBuddy. Unlike a gantry-style plotter, this uses a pair of stepper motors and inverse kinematics to move the pen to its position. That's fun enough on its own, but this project is a real who's who in Arduino inputs and outputs. There's a handful of push buttons, a slide potentiometer, a rotary encoder, a joystick, plus this LCD display and the stepper motors to drive the arms. Each one of these gets its own section in the Instructable, with a bunch of tips on working with them to get them working with the project. This looks like a really handy resource to keep around just for that sake alone. Plus, plotters are always cool. While poking around Reddit, I found this Modular Fightstick by SteeGuys. There's a central brain unit in the lower right segment, and 2 other segments for control inputs. And that's what's so cool about this thing. Each segment is held together with magnets and some 3D printed hooks, and you can just pull the thing apart and snap it back together in the configuration you want. Whether you want a standard layout or buttons instead of a joystick, or maybe you want mechanical keys. And it's even crazier that it all manages the different inputs on the fly, even in the middle of your game. There's not a whole lot of detail in this project at the moment, but it sounds like the creator has plans to open source the project sometime soon. If this is something you're into, watch this space. And finally, we have a useless machine by Baldy Make Stuff comprised of 15 different mechanisms. Steam engines, universal joints, reversing hoists, Maltese crosses, you name it. The video is a satisfying watch, with just the sounds of each mechanism in operation and the sounds of its assembly. But the reveal at the end, with each mechanism connected together and all working in concert, is genuinely playful and mesmerizing. Check it out! Time for some tips and tools. Pask Makes has this fantastic video about parallel pliers. Most of the time, a regular set of pliers is all you need to get a firm hold on something that you're working with. But if you need to grip something with parallel sides, that's when you need parallel pliers. These pliers have jaws that remain parallel to one another when they open and close. This video is a build video where he makes his own set, but you can also find them from just about any tool seller. Over on Adafruit, Liz Clark has a guide to making this CircuitPython-powered monitor and controller for Octoprint. This is running on the ESP32 Reverse TFT Feather, which has a TFT display and 3-button interface on the back of the board, perfect for compact projects. Even though there's just 3 buttons, there's a ton of functionality in this controller. You can preheat the nozzle when it's not printing, and if a print is running, you'll see a progress bar and you can pause or cancel the print. It's pretty handy. On his channel, Zack Freedman took a field trip to SparkFun to check out their PCB manufacturing facility. If you're not familiar with how modern electronics are assembled, this video is a real treat. He goes to full nerd depth on the pick and place machines, how they work, how components are loaded into them, and how it gets the components onto the board for soldering. His deep dive alone on the speed of modern pick and place machines and the multiple tool heads to get parts off of reels and onto boards is well worth the price of admission. But the whole thing is just a blast from start to finish. And finally, Keith Decent wants you to stop wasting epoxy. If you work with epoxy, chances are you use one of these silicone mats to protect your work surface. More often than not, you mix up more epoxy than you need, and the rest just goes to waste. Keith's own design for a silicone mat is essentially an arrangement of molds that you can pour that leftover epoxy into to make more tools. There's scrapers and stir sticks, combs, painter's pyramids, and a whole bunch of other stuff. I'm sure the tools won't hold up to a ton of use, but it's better than just letting that leftover epoxy go to waste. It's a neat idea. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we've got the latest in Becky Stern's teaching series about electronics and Arduino. This one is all about Arduino libraries. Arduino libraries are bits of code that can be accessed through the IDE that make it easier to work with various components. Whether you want to play with addressable RGB LEDs, or displays, reading sensors, and tons more. Becky's video peels back the mystery of libraries so you can easily get a sense of what they're doing behind the scenes and how you can use them in your projects. Arduino libraries can make just about any project you can think of possible. This video can help you understand them a lot better. All right, and that does it for this week's show. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, and hit subscribe so you won't miss next week's. Speaking of next week, Donald is taking a short break, so I'll be back with you for next week's show, but he'll be back in this spot the following week. As always, big thanks to DigiKey for making this all possible, and to you for watching. Take care, we'll see you soon.